disrespected because of the way the Clippers kind of finagled things down the stretch and lost to a couple of lottery bound teams to, it seemed like, to get in your bracket or to get you guys?
No. I mean, there can be plenty of reasons, but I don't really pay attention to that, you know. I'm more focused on us.
They look good. They're very good. You know, the structure of their team has changed slightly. But, you know, with the acquisition of Rondo, they've gotten tougher, better defensively, and they've added a playmaker. You know, their situation with their bigs has been a little bit fluid with Ibaka being out, but he's been back in a couple games toward the end and appears to have gotten his footing. So I don't know, the word is that they're fully healthy. And so, you know, they're a contending team. There's no question about that.
It's tough for me to pick the Mavericks, but I look at it from the perspective. I do think they have more going for them in this series than they did last year. I assume Kristaps Porzingis is going to be available for every game. When they did not have him in that series last year, the series really changed. He was really good against them last year. They didn't have Jalen Brunson last year, who has become, I guess you could say, a role player, but I think a key role player for this team. He sparks them time after time off the bench, has become a really nice NBA player. They didn't have him last year because of injury. And the guy we had on, Dwight Powell, was not on this team last year because of injury. I love the way he's playing. I love the way Hardaway's playing. Will it be enough to knock off a team that I think is better? And I think we're in for even a better series than what we had last year. The way you got pushed around by these guys last year, you could interpret what they did at the end of the season as, well, let's just avoid the Lakers and let's play the Mavericks. How would you not be so fired up, so challenged as an athlete to play these guys?
Right.
And I hope they play like that.
Well, the Mavericks certainly over the last 16 games better than any team in the NBA at 12-4. Ty Lue made it very clear that he preferred rest over rust and sat down a whole bunch of guys, went 6-6. But with a week off basically for both of these teams before playing this game, how much does that even matter?
I think there's no excuses now. Both teams are almost at full strength. You know, Dallas is missing Redick, but other than that, they're at full strength.
9-4 Mavs, 4 minutes gone by. Both Clipper baskets scored by Zubats. The rest of the team is 0-6.
Finished by Doncic. A foul on Patrick Beverley.
Clippers trail 12-6. Denny Smith, a seductive ball fake, rises inside with the flush. Doncic down the lane, runs into George, draws the contact but not a whistle. Gets his own rebound and smooches it up and in. Here's a drive by Luka inside. Finds Hardaway, spots him in the corner. Yes, sir! Strings for Hardaway. Richardson has it back from Luka to beat the buzzer. Slams it through and scores! Count it! Brunson with the drive. He's fouled and scores! And one, Jalen Brunson.
Hit it.
Denny Smith passed up the first shot opportunity, but he does not pass that one up. Drills the three. Mavericks retake the lead.
They can really shoot that three ball.
So now it's Doncic. Nobody gets the Hardaway, so he takes it all the way to the rim and gets the layup, and the Mavericks lead by 7. Doncic, look at Rondo right in his grill. They double. Porzingis on the drive, finishes against Leonard. Great ball movement by the Mavs.
With 5 seconds to Leonard, he'll shoot a three. Again, short, rebound Hardaway, and that will do it as the Mavericks, for the first time since the Western Conference Finals of 2011, have grabbed the first game of a playoff series as they go into Los Angeles and beat the Clippers 113-103.
The Mavericks defeated the Clippers in Game 1 here in Los Angeles, 113-103, and we're joined by the star of the game, Luka Doncic. You got a triple-double tonight. You weren't one of the MVP finalists. Was that a little extra motivation maybe tonight?
No, I don't really care about MVP. You have great players in this league. What's important is championship, and obviously that's our goal this season.
And, of course, Tim Hardaway Jr., your backcourt mate, he's been in the starting lineup, he's been out of the starting lineup. What can you say about his performance tonight?
Oh, amazing. You know, he's been, like you said, in and out. You know, it's tough as a player. You don't know when you're going to start, when you're going to be off the bench. I think he did an amazing job. He's been doing this all season, and he's a special key for us.
Luka, congratulations. Thank you.
Thank you.
The start to the game was important. It gave us momentum. You know, great teams are always going to make runs. When they came back and took the lead in the second half, we really exhibited great poise, and we stayed aggressive. That's what you got to do in a playoff series. I thought Porzingis was very patient in this game. He's got a top five defensive player in the world guarding him, in Kawhi Leonard. They have that much respect for his abilities at the offensive end. And he did a very good job of staying patient and finding ways to create advantages as the game went on. His discipline, his patience, and the big free throws were huge at the end of the game. And then the dunk, kind of put a cap on it. Doncic was great. Finney Smith was great. Kleber, those guys all dug in really hard defensively against two of the best players in the world. We've just got to maintain the edge. We'll look at the film and see what things we can do better. There are many. They'll do the same. And then we got to get ready for Tuesday.